So you just got a new ASIC miner and you need some help getting it set up to mine. Well, don't worry, because in this video I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about setting up any kind of ASIC miner, as well as give you full step-by-step guides for each of the most common ASIC brands, including Bitmain, Goldshell, IceRiver, Whatsminer, iBeLink, and more. So either keep watching to learn all of the basics that you need to know before you get started, or if you're impatient, you can use the video chapter to jump directly to the setup for your specific miner. But before you do that, let's hear a quick word from our sponsor. Coin Mining Central is an online store for ASIC miners, and there's no doubt that right now, ASIC mining is by far looking like the most profitable type of mining, and the miners that I'm personally most interested in right now would probably be the Bitmain L7 and E9 Pro, as well as the Jasminer X16Q. And what's cool about Coin Mining Central is that they always offer free worldwide express shipping, and I've always felt fully comfortable recommending them to you guys, and here's why. As opposed to most other ASIC vendors that are based overseas, Coin Mining Central is based and run out of England, Europe, where they have to adhere to the very strict regulations for customer support and personal detail protection that we have over here. And of course, all brand new miners come with a full manufacturer warranty as well. And because of this, Coin Mining Central has been a highly trusted ASIC miner store for miners like you and me for over 5 years at this point. They also care about this community, being very active and reachable on social media, and they've also provided loads of exclusive discount codes for you guys that you can use together with the link in the video description to save big on any miner that you want to get. And speaking of prices, I don't know if you've noticed, but ASIC prices have been dropping dramatically these past few months, so right now could be a very good time to stock up on some cheap hardware before the crypto market recovers, especially considering you get the already competitive pricing that Coin Mining Central has, plus the free worldwide shipping, plus the exclusive discount codes that I mentioned. So go check that out today. I'll have all of those discount codes and the exclusive link for you down in the video description. So before we can set up your new ASIC miner, there are a few things you need. The first thing is a wallet address for the coin you are wanting to mine on your new hardware. A good place to start is to visit the official website for the coin project you are wanting to mine, and they will most likely have a full dedicated section on the website about where you can find the different wallets for the coin. For example, if you just bought a Caspa miner like this K0 Pro I got here, we can open Caspa's official website, and here you can see on the resources page they have a whole bunch of supported wallets listed. The general advice here is that if you're wanting to mine and hold your crypto long term, to go with either some sort of hardware wallet or paper wallet. The hardware wallet I recommend, which works with most mineable coins, is the Tangem wallet. I'll link that down in the video description together with an exclusive discount code just for you guys. However, if your plan is just mine and sell or exchange your mined coins frequently, basically any type of wallet works well enough. Just hold the coins for a few hours until you transfer them to the exchange. So now that we have our wallet address that we want our mined coins to be deposited into, the second thing we need is a mining pool. Now, okay, you don't technically need a mining pool, but setting up your own node for solo mining goes beyond the scope of this video. So, for all intents and purposes here, we need a mining pool. And a mining pool is basically just a way to mine together with a bunch of other people in order to minimize the luck factor involved in mining and get paid fairly for your mining efforts. If you want to learn more about what mining pools are and how they work, I'll link a video about that down in the video description. But to find a mining pool for the coin you are wanting to mine with your new ASIC, I recommend looking that coin up on a website like miningpoolstats.stream. So we'll open that website and let's stick with Caspa as our example here. So let's search for that on the side here and click on it. And as you can see, we have a whole bunch of options here in terms of mining pools for this coin. Now, I won't be able to go into which pools are good or not and why in this video, but for this example we will go with Hero Miners because I personally like them. I've had nothing but great experiences with them, they've sponsored the channel before, and they've also done a lot of different giveaways for you guys. Now, one thing I do want to say here is that you probably want to go for one of the pools near the top of the list for whatever coin you are mining in order to make sure you are getting consistent payouts. However, maybe not one of the ones exactly at the top of the list, because by avoiding those, you are helping decentralization of the coin, which then supports the security of the network for the coin you are mining. So, in other words, even based on that, Hero Miners is actually a great option for us here. And so, next step is to click on the link to their pool here, or any other pool you might choose for whatever coin you are mining, and it will take you to that pool's website. And once you're on the pool's website, there should be a section called something like start mining or how to connect or anything along those lines. Some pools might require you to sign up for an account, but most pools don't. And once you've found that how to start mining section, here on Hero Miners you get there by clicking on start at the top menu. There are two things we need. The first is the mining pool server address for the one that is physically closest to you. This is to get the fastest possible connection between your miner and the pool. You can see here that there are options all over the world with Hero Miners. The closest one to me personally is the Germany one, so I will copy and save that one. The second thing we need is the port number, and any good pool should have them listed out with clear instructions on what they are for, as you can see on the page here. As for this example, I'm setting up my KS0 Pro, so we can see that the port for me is 1207. We now have the three things we need to set up our new ASIC miner: our wallet address, our mining pool server address, and the mining pool port number. Next, let's quickly go through the general approach for setting up any ASIC miner, and then we will get into specific tutorials for each ASIC brand. The next step is to plug your new ASIC miner into power and internet. Once the miner is turned on and connected to your network, the next step is to find it on our network to access its web interface in order to input our wallet address and mining pool details. And don't worry, it's a lot simpler than it might sound. Basically, every new device you connect to your network gets assigned its own internal IP address. You can think of it as a web address directly to the device, which only works if you are connected to the same network as that device is. So, our next step is to find this internal IP for the miner that we just connected to our network. And there are many different ways of doing this, and some ASIC manufacturers even provide their own tools to help you find the ASICs. However, a fail-safe way of doing it that I always recommend is to just get a basic, free network scanning app on your phone and use that. These types of apps are a dime a dozen, and I'm sure most, if not all of them, probably work absolutely fine. One of the ones I've been using before is called Fing. It's available on both iOS and Android, but I'd recommend you always do your own research before just blindly trusting and downloading any app like this. Now, basically, once you've found and installed a network scanning app that you're happy with, just make sure your phone or device is connected to the same network as your ASIC miner. And it doesn't matter if the phone is on Wi-Fi and the ASIC is on Ethernet, by the way. Then just click on the Scan Network button in your app. The process might be slightly different depending on what app you're using, but if you've done it correctly, it should give you a long list of IP numbers for all the devices connected on your network, as well as the device names. Now you just have to go through this list until you find the IP for your ASIC miner. They will usually be named to make them easier to find, but if you're unlucky, they might just have some sort of generic name, and then you're basically going to have to use the process of elimination to figure out which IP address belongs to your new miner. Once you got that IP though, just open up a web browser on any device connected to the same network as your ASIC miner. For example, on the device you just used the network scanning app on, paste that IP address into the web browser's address field and hit enter. You should now be greeted by some sort of login screen. If not, try powering your miner off and back on again, or you might have copied the wrong IP from the list in your network scanning app, or your device is not on the same network as your miner is. Now, you need to refer to the manual or online documentation for your specific miner to find out what the default login details that you need here are. However, in most cases here, both the username and password is just root. But as I said, you should be able to find the details for your specific miner super easy if it came with a manual or online with just a quick Google search. After you've logged in, you'll see the full web interface for your miner. It might be in Chinese though, so you might need to find a little button, usually at the top right, to switch from Chinese to English. And at that point, you'll probably notice that your ASIC miner is already up and mining, although not to your wallet address, but to the ASIC manufacturer's address. Pretty sneaky, but we'll just change that in a few seconds, so I guess it's alright. And to do that, we need to look for a page or section on the web interface, usually called something like Miner Setup or Mining Settings or Miner Configuration or something along those lines. In here, there will usually be three fields. The first one for entering your mining pool's server address and port number. The way to enter that is just to type stratum plus TCP colon forward slash then the server address, then another colon, and then the port number. Now, it might be slightly different if you're connecting through a different protocol like SSL, But on the other hand, if you're doing that, you probably already know what you are doing, so you wouldn't need to watch a video like this to begin with. In the next field is where you will enter your wallet address. Or for cases where the pool requires you to sign up, you might instead need to enter your username here. In most cases, you can just paste your wallet address in here though, and if you want, you can then add a period and enter a name for the specific miner you are setting up. This name will then show up on the mining pool and help you separate your different miners if you have multiple, but in most cases it isn't required. Finally, the last field is if your pool requires you to have a password, which it most likely doesn't unless it's one of those pools that require you to sign up for an account. In that case, just enter the password here, but otherwise you can probably just leave the field empty or put a lowercase x. After that, just hit whatever save button there might be. Sometimes it's called just save, sometimes it's save and apply, sometimes it's just apply, sometimes it's save and restart the miner. I'm sure you can figure it out. After this, you can go back to the pool website and there should be a field for you to enter your wallet address in order to track your ASIC miner's progress on the pool to see its hash rate and its mining earnings. However, just keep in mind that sometimes it can take up to an hour for the miner to actually show up on your pool dashboard after you first connect it. Although with that in mind, if it's taking longer than that or it's just not showing up at all on your pool dashboard, you might need to restart your ASIC before these new mining settings take effect. And most ASICs will have a clearly labeled restart miner button in their web interface. And while you're looking for that, it could also be a good time to check that your new pool and wallet settings properly saved, as well as if your ASIC has some sort of connection error from an eventual typo in the server address or anything along those lines which might be what's causing it to not properly connect to the pool. So, there you have it. That is all you really need to know in order to set up and start mining with basically any ASIC miner. But with that out of the way, let's end this video with a speedrun going through that same process step by step on miners from all of the most commonly used ASIC brands. So starting with Bitmain, find your miner's internal IP like I showed you earlier in the video and then open that in your web browser. Login here is just root and root, then you might need to change the language to English at the top right, then on the left side click on settings, then fill in the mining pool, server address and port in the field like this. Enter your wallet address or pool username in the second field, probably just the wallet address unless you specifically know your pool uses usernames, and then follow that with a period and then the name you want your miner to show up as in the pool dashboard. And in the third field, enter the pool password if there is one, but there probably isn't, and in that case you can just leave it blank or enter a lowercase x. You can then enter two backup pools below this, which the miner will connect to if it fails to connect to the first one for some reason. Then you hit save, wait for it to save, and then you might also want to click on restart miner at the bottom as well, just for good measure. Next up is Goldshell, which makes finding your miner's web interface even easier. Just open find.goldshell.com in your browser and you should see a list of all the Goldshell miners on your network. You might need to change the language to English at the top right though. After that, just click on the little cogwheel icon for the miner you're wanting to set up. You might then need to change the language to English at the top right again, and then click on unlock. The username here is admin, and the password is just numbers 12345678 9. After that, click on pool settings in the middle or miner to the left. They both bring you to the same page. You then want to start by removing the pre-applied settings by clicking the remove button and then OK. Then click on add and enter the pool address and port number like this. Then in miner name, enter your wallet address or pool username in the second field. Probably just the wallet address unless you specifically know that your pool uses usernames. And then follow that with a period and then the name you want your miner to show up as on the pool dashboard. And in the third field, enter the pool password if there is one, but there probably isn't. And in that case, you can just leave it blank or enter a lowercase x. Hit apply and that is it. If you want, you can then click the add button again to add backup pools, which the miner will connect to if it for some reason fails to connect to the first pool. Next, let's move on to iceRiver. First, find your miner's internal IP like I showed you earlier in the video, and then open it in your web browser. The login here is admin and the password is numbers 12345678. Then you might need to change the language to English top right. Then on the left side, click on mining settings. Then fill in the mining pool server address and port in the first field like this. Enter your wallet address or pool username in the second field. probably just the wallet address unless you specifically know your pool user's usernames, and then follow that with a period and the name you want your miner to show up as in the pool dashboard. And in the third field, enter the pool password if there is one, but there probably isn't, and in that case you can just leave it blank or enter a lowercase x. You can then enter two backup pools which the miner will connect to if it fails to connect to the first one for some reason. Then you hit save, wait for it to save, and then you might want to click on restart at the bottom to reboot your miner as well, just for good measure. Next up is Whatsminer. Again, start by finding your miner's internal IP like I showed you earlier in the video, and then open that in your web browser. The login here is admin, and the password is also admin. Then in the top menu, hover over configuration and select miner configuration. Then fill in the mining pool server address and port in the pool 1 field like this. You might need to select custom in the dropdown before it lets you fill it in though. Then enter your wallet address or pool username in the second field, probably just the wallet address unless you specifically know that your pool uses usernames, and then follow that with a period and then the name you want your miner to show up as on the pool dashboard. And then in the third field, enter the pool password if there is one, but there probably isn't, and in that case you can just leave it blank or enter a lowercase x. You can then also add some backup pools, which the miner will connect to if it for some reason fails to connect to the first pool you entered. You do this by following the same steps for the pool 2 and pool 3 fields below. Once that's done, just hit save and apply. And once that's done, you might also want to go to system in the top menu and hit reboot to restart your miner as well, just for good measure. Next up is iBeLink. Again, start by finding your miner's internal IP, just like I showed you earlier in the video, and open that in your web browser. To log in, enter iBeLink as both the username and password. Then just click on the big red config button in the middle of the screen, and you might want to start by just deleting all the settings that are already saved here. Then fill in the mining pool server address and port in the field like this. Then enter your wallet address or pool username in the second field, probably just the wallet address unless you specifically know that your pool uses usernames, and then follow that with a period and then the name you want your miner to show up as in the pool dashboard. And in the third field, enter the pool password if there is one, but there probably isn't, and in that case you can just leave it blank or enter a lowercase x. Save these settings by clicking add pool, and if you want, you can repeat this process to add backup pools that the miner will connect to if it fails to connect to the first pool you added for some reason. At this point, you can also choose to restart or reboot your miner by using the top right buttons just for good measure. Alright, let's move on to Jasminer. Start by finding your miner's internal IP like I showed you earlier in the video, and then open that in your web browser. The login here is just root and root. Then in the top menu, click on settings and then miner. Then fill in the mining pool server address and port in the first field like this. Enter your wallet address or pool username in the second field, probably just the wallet address unless you specifically know that your pool uses usernames, and then follow that with a period and then the name you want your miner to show up as in the pool dashboard. And in the third field, enter the pool password if there is one, but there probably isn't, and in that case you can just leave it blank or enter a lowercase x. You can also fill in the sections below to add backup pools that the miner will connect to if it for some reason fails to connect to the first pool. Then just click on submit and wait for your new settings to save. At that point, you might also want to click on system in the top menu and hit reboot, just for good measure. Finally, let's wrap up with iPollo. Again, start by finding your miner's internal IP like I showed you earlier in the video, and open that in your web browser. The login here is just root and root, then on the left click on miner configuration, and in the pool configuration field, fill in the mining pool server address and port number in the first field like this. Enter your wallet address or pool username in the second field, probably just the wallet address unless you specifically know that your pool uses usernames, and then follow that with a period and then the name you want your miners to show up as in the pool dashboard. And in the third field, enter the pool password if there is one, but there probably isn't, and in that case just leave it blank or enter a lowercase x. You can also fill in the sections below to add backup pools that the miner will connect to if it for some reason fails to connect to the first pool you added. After that, just click save and apply, and once the miner have done that, you might also want to click on the restart button to reboot your miner just for good measure.